Graham, and it's Graham with the tip up ahead to Smith. And Mariah misses it, and here comes FGCU the other way. Kiri Jewett-Giles.
Well, David, one of the things you don't want with your Coppin State, they ran a perfect jump ball play there with the layup. And you got to make those shots in a game that's going to be where there may be a little talent discrepancy.
Adderley, 6 seconds. Staroditschka for three. She has struggled from downtown Washington hitting the glass. Can't convert. Mentioned Staroditschka has struggled from distance this year, although she did hit both her threes Monday night in the win against Abilene Christian.
In critical times, too.
And it's been a surprise that Staroditschka has struggled shooting the three, because Jay Webb, she ended last year, final 6 weeks of the season. She was a threat from the arc. And an offensive foul on the pass. Kaya Coleman picks up the first foul of the game. Dwayne Burroughs in his third year at his alma mater. Deep three from the far side, rims out for UL. Coleman was a player at Coppin State, but ironically, Jay Webb, he played baseball.
And he was on that, he was a student when Coppin State actually won the MEAC and went to the NCAA tournament.
And nearly 90 seconds in, and a couple of turnovers, bunch of missed shots. The only coach FGCU has ever had. 504 career wins. You see 443 of them here with the Eagles. It's the Eagles against the Lady Eagles. Some schools still choosing to use Lady. Deep three from the far side. Rims out by Sahai Corby. Still looking for our first points. Nearly 2 minutes in. UL for three.
I tell you, both teams are in a drought here. They really are.
Maybe it's the early tip. I think most teams used to play in around 7 o'clock,
yes,
as opposed to 5 o'clock. And so far, everybody is cold. Washington picked up the offensive foul, going for the rebound. First foul of the game on her and on the Eagles. And we have trouble as the clocks were not started on time. Jay Webb, you mentioned Coppin State and their tough schedule. Well, how tough is it, you ask?
Yes, how tough is it, David?
Thank you, Jay Webb. Sixth-ranked Mississippi State at the time they played them. Ninth-ranked Maryland. 13th-ranked Minnesota. 25th-ranked West Virginia, all on the road. In fact, the Lady Eagles, 8 of their first 9 games on the road. They also played Virginia and the Ohio Bobcats on the road. And I mention Ohio because there's a connection between FGCU and Ohio.
Bobby Bolton, the head coach there.
And so one would think that maybe Coppin State, an advantage having played Ohio, and the foul on the drive will result in free throws. Brooke Fields will go to the line. You would think, since FGCU, unique style, it's difficult when you only see them once in a while to play them. But if you're the Lady Eagles, you saw Ohio a few weeks ago.
Same offense.
There you go. And Fields, a 71% free throw shooter, hits
we'll
the first
check
free
the
throw.
Record, but Bobby Bolton may be one of the few coaches that has a winning record against Semesco.
I thought they split the home and home.
Well,
we'll have to check that.
Remember when he was at that school, the Blooming something?
You know, it's dinner time, Jay Webb. Don't say Blooming because I'm thinking onion. 2.5 minutes gone by. The Eagles still looking for their first points, and now they trail by 5 as Kaya Coleman hits the far wing 3. That's just her second from downtown on the year.
Well, Coppin State is not a 3-point shooting team.
Nice backdoor cut, but Jewett-Giles with the miss. Adderley the rebound. Ball didn't hit the rim, however. So shot clock continues to wind down. UL way off on the 3. Foul on the rebound
You know, David, one of the things I'd like to see Tatiana do, because she's a beast on the boards, is I'd like to see her put that ball back up when she's down there and just put the layup in instead of taking it back out.
Second foul on Coleman, who just hit the three a moment ago. So Kaya Coleman has to sit down with two fouls in the first 3 minutes. Off the inbounds, and Washington comes up way short, airballing the three. Still 15 seconds. Euro step for Jewett Giles. And is that what you're talking about there? Adderley not putting it up?
Yeah, see.
UL penetrates, splits the double team, and scores.
And that's one of the traits that UL has picked up end of last year and beginning of this year, is where she can really put the ball on the floor and hit that little eight-footer. That's a, I think they call it a block there.
Foul on FGCU, and it's on Washington, and that's her second. So Washington with two, and Coleman for Coppin State with two here in the early going.
I think we'll see Alyssa Blair.
Chandler Ryan and the aforementioned Alyssa Blair will check in. Jewett Giles and Washington check out.
Well, Chance Graham does everything for the Coppin State Lady Eagles.
Including hit free throws, two for two there.
That's what Ryan Chandler does off the bench, like a microwave, lit it up.
Well, Chandler Ryan assuming the role of Jessica Catani from a year ago, and not only was Jessica so on fire, as is Graham from downtown.
It's Graham. She's inside and outside, David. Well, a little press here.
Well, Coppin State probably looked at the tape from Abilene two nights ago, and the Eagles really struggled against the pressure. 20-plus turnovers. Barely crossed the timeline there. UL gets a step and fouled on the drive.
Let's see who the foul's on here.
It's on Mariah Smith, her first, third team foul. Back to Chandler Ryan. Remember, Catani was the first guard off the bench last year, the first shooter, and she had an incredible knack as the season went on to hit her very first shot coming off the bench. Did it for like 6 weeks straight and got the nickname from us that she, Catani, missed. UL misses the free throw. Adderley the rebound, and there's Ryan with the three.
She must be listening to the broadcast, David.
And Ryan not only having to take Katani's spot on the team this year, but she is literally fulfilling the role the exact same way that Jessica did.
Yeah, very much so.
UL with the great defensive play, the block. They reset the shot clock inadvertently. 10 seconds now for the Lady Eagles to shoot. So after a cold first nearly 3 minutes of the game, both teams have hit a couple threes. Three seconds to shoot. Good defense by Ryan.
Very good defense by Ryan.
Sarah Ditchka now in transition. Blair.
She thought about it.
Been struggling a bit with her shot lately. On a couple of scoreless games before scoring 4 points against Abilene, and UL with the drive to give FGCU the lead.
See, the beauty of UL now is that they know she can shoot the three. Little pump fake, puts it on the floor, goes to the hole with a nice finish.
Hesitation, and then the three by Graham is off the mark.
That's a good looking shot by Graham.
UL with the fake once again. Blair will shoot it this time. She started the season red hot from three, which was the area of her game that she had to work on from a year ago. She's gone cold from downtown here in the last couple weeks.
Yes. Ooh, that's a little walk in there.
Those shoes were made for walking, and it leads us to our first media timeout. Nazuel